Welcome to another Reros Online related video. Today I want to talk about the recent changes to coal engines and also give you guys my idea on how I would handle the rebalancing of everything. Overall, I absolutely appreciate that the devs have finally done something in order to cut down on the amount of time those engines can run for without needing a coal resupply. I still think that what they've done falls short by an order of magnitude. I'll get more in depth about that in a moment. Just note that the way this was apparently handled overall is by every time you put your shovel into the coal bunker and pull out some coal, the new setting that you have for coal consumption will factor in how much coal you actually p reduce the bunker for. So it doesn't change anything how much coal you have on the shovel, but if you have highest setting for coal consumption, you're now pulling out 4 units of coal every time you interact with it. Used to be one, and you can actually already also set it to 0. And that's kind of bizarre because ultimately, whether you have the setting to not consuming coal at all or using the harshest setting with a factor of 4, you will still need to shovel the exact same amount of coal out of the tender into the firebox in order to keep the engine running. It's just that with the offsetting for consumption, the tender will stay at the same level as before. And with the 4x setting, it will deplete by 4x the amount as from before the update. So that's what it does, and I feel that's kind of weird, but it's definitely a good value to adjust, so you don't run into any of the issues having to adjust the bunker capacity directly, because with people having bought their engines already, that could run into some issues with recalculating how much there should be in there. But I think it still ultimately falls short in a few ways. So let's get into the spreadsheet and talk about what we have here. So the spreadsheet right now is incomplete. I'll be revealing more parts as the video goes on. But first up, in order to make adjustments, we need to figure out what is going on with the game right now. I haven't included the new engine since I don't have any values for that, but for the most part, I'll be focusing on the Ruby Basin and the Cook Mogul slash Tween Sea anyways, because Ruby Basin has the lowest amount of capacity with only 1,000 units. So yeah, beforehand, that was 1,000 shovels that he would pull out of there. And the Mogul and Tween Sea have 6x the amount. And that translates to a duration for the Tween Sea to 1,200 hours before it needs a resupply of coal. And for Ruby Basin, 200 hours. I've used the Ruby Basin for months as a main engine on one of my playthroughs, and I think I got down to about half the amount of stuff in the bunker. So even 200 hours is far too much, and since the new factor introduced cuts it down to 300 hours for the Tween Sea, that's still way above anything that it should be. So let's talk about my goals next. With my rebalancing, I want to have some really harsh values, and these would be for the highest consumption rates in the game. I would still want there to be a setting for people who want to not resupply their engines all that much. And that would be like maybe double the duration before you need to resupply, 4x that, 10x, who knows? But for the harshest value, I think it should be mostly single-digit numbers. And here they are. This is where I would like the engines to end up, or at least in the ballpark. And yeah, that also means that there is now a factor between what it used to be to what we need to achieve. This is more for me to see what I can actually, or what I need to do in order to achieve the numbers, and how much the difference will be between before and after. So it's a reduction factor of 50 for the Ruby Basin, and everything else is far beyond 100, so everything else needs to be adjusted at least twice as much as the Ruby Basin, so that can be a bit tricky. But I think overall the reduction factors are maybe a bit more confusing than helpful, so let me get rid of them again. Just note that they clearly state that Ruby Basin only needs to be half as harshly adjusted in order to arrive here than the rest of the engines. And I also want to keep the ratio of the capacity the same. So I will not be adjusting these in any way. I won't be anyways because again that could lead to some issues. I make sure that the Ruby Basin will still have 1/6 of the amount of shovels in it than the Twin Sea, but I'll be adjusting other values in order to finally arrive over here. There's also another thing that we need to take a look at, and that is the firebox capacity. This is quite important because if I only adjust the burn rate, you could end up with a scenario where you would just start the engine, get on the road, and then just keep shoveling and not being able to do anything else. So in order to deal with that, I also want to do something about this and make sure that it works out properly. So this is again what I have seen in the game as of right now, but it's also a bit of a guesstimation. The most important guessing value right here is the base time. I think you need to resupply your firebox about every 30 minutes, so that's the time it takes from being completely full to depleting to 0%. And that's for the engines with the least amount of capacity. And yeah, this whole thing, how do I explain it? The most prevalent value in the game for the firebox is the percentage, but a lot of engines have actually different absolute capacities. For example, the starter engine, the Betsy, that one has like 50 capacity, and each of the, what was it? Each of the firewood pieces actually has a fuel value of 10. So you need to put 5 of them into it in order to get to the maximum capacity, which will then show you the 100%. The absolute capacity used to be shown in the UI, but I don't know if it's still a thing. But yeah, just know that some of them have higher capacity, and meaning that they still take longer to get to 100%, but that just means that you need to put more firm stuff in there. 100% for one engine isn't 100% for the other. That's what I meant to say. Bloody damn it. Okay. But yeah, this is something that I think is the way it works. I know that for most of the engines it's about 3.5 shovels in order to get to 100% capacity, but at least for one of them is 4. I don't know if this is all correct, but they are close enough anyways, and we are going to take a look at what I'm going to adjust them for in a moment. So let's get into my whole adjustment thing and what I've done over here. First up, let's talk about the values that I could actually adjust in order to get the new duration of travel before needing the resupply. I could adjust the amount of units that you get out of a tender each shovel, and I decided to also do that because that's really quite useful. However, in order to preserve the same ratios between the capacities, I decided to make this factor the same for all. And after a bit back and forth testing out a few values, I arrived at an adjustment for units per shovel to be 12. So every time you get a shovel of coal out of a tender, the tender capacity will decrease by 12. And that's the same across the board. Could maybe still be adjusted, but for what I arrived here, I think this is a pretty good value. The next one would be the burn rate for the firebox. And this is a factor which affects how quickly you go from 100% firebox capacity to zero. And this is where I make adjustments so that the engines come a bit closer together. And over here we see that it's from 4.5 for the Ruby Basin, since it has a low capacity anyways, all the way up to 9 for the Mogul, Twin Sea, and the Lima, with a 10-mile coming in at a factor of 8. So this will leave us with new adjusted durations that are a bit off my target, but I think still pretty decent. 3.7 hours would be for the Ruby Basin before it runs out of coal, 6.9 for the 10 mile, Lima coming in at 8.3, and the last two engines at 11.1. I think there's still maybe some argument to be made about trying to put the Ruby Basin a bit higher and the Cook Mogul and Finzi a bit lower, or just adjust the 10-mile Lima and the other engines to all be a bit lower and the Ruby Basin could stay as it is right now. But I think overall this is pretty decent for what I had in mind. Doesn't need to exactly hit the numbers, because those are something that you will never see, but you will feel the difference. So yeah, after that I again have the factors going from the old to the new one, but I think just looking at the absolute numbers, this is definitely close enough. So the next thing would be how the firebox behaves, because with a difference of a factor of 9 for some of these engines, you could end up in a scenario where you put new coal in about every 3 minutes or so, and I think that would be a bit much. So I also decided to adjust the capacity for the firebox, and let me open this up from this end. So we have a new time to burn, and we have a new capacity in shovels. I also have another factor before that, that is just how much I adjusted the capacity by. That isn't really all that useful right here, but it makes it easier to adjust how all of these values, how all of that works. And yeah, instead of having a 3.5 shovel capacity for the Ruby Basin, it is now up to 5.25, resulting in a straight up 10 minutes time to burn through a full load of coal in the tender. Oh no, of coal in the firebox. The next one for the 10 mile, I went up from 3.5 shovels to 7. And that gives me 7.5 minutes where I can do something else. Lima goes up from 4 shovels to 9. And it ends up with 8.6 minutes before you need to refuel. And the other engine goes up by a factor of 8 and gives me 7.6 minutes. So yeah, that's pretty much how that all works. I think some of it could still be adjusted. It feels a bit weird having the Ruby Basin, a very strong engine with a low amount of capacity for coal, being the one that can go the longest without needing to be refueled. So maybe this factor could still go a bit further up or something, but that would also reduce the duration. And yeah, maybe this could be adjusted again. It's a balancing act. There are a lot of things that you can consider. And I think something like this might be a good jumping off point to put that in the game on the beta branch, see how it behaves, see how people like it, and then make adjustments going forward from here. But I think in order to make the entire thing work out and have it really work well, you need to adjust a lot more than just the units per shovel. Burn rate needs to be adjusted, and the firebox capacity also needs to be adjusted in order to make everything come together. And I hope it is what I achieved here to some degree at least. Again, if I had any chance to do this in-game, I would absolutely go for a test run, and it would likely need to be a long one in order to really figure out how I feel about all of this. But, well, I think both the adjustments to make the duration a lot lower and also one to increase the frequency with which you need to actually shovel some more coal into the firebox, those are both adjustments that need to be made at some point. So, yeah, that's pretty much it for this one. I think there was something else that I wanted to mention, but the whole idea of making some settings that allow you to maybe have this a bit more relaxed. I think for the most part it should be the burn rate in the firebox. However, I feel this needs to be two different things here. Maybe not two different settings, but while it would make sense to increase the burn rate here to a factor where you don't run out that often anymore, maybe you would just reduce the amount of coal you use up with every shovel. I don't think the same ratios should apply to the stuff over here. Because if you do that, you could easily jump up to this taking hours until you need to put more coal into the engine. Maybe it really should just be this factor up front here, because that wouldn't affect anything else apart from the duration. But yeah, I think overall this is a better way of handling things, and I would love to see this in game, at least for testing purposes. So yeah, let me know what you think about this. I hope I made it clear what my goal here was and how I went about it. It is a bit dry with it only being numbers and not really much else to show here, but I'd at least try to explain it. So thanks for watching, and in case this might be the last video that I make this year, hopefully next year back with a new PC finally once more. Let me wish you all a Merry Christmas. Happy New Year, happy holiday, no matter how you decide to spend it, and see you back in half a month or something. I don't know, I hope the PC stuff works out, otherwise I likely might be making some more videos like this here. But I would love to just get back into the game now and actually experience the past few updates. Anyways, until then, bye bye, have a good time, see ya.